Hey there, welcome to WP Beginner and thanks for tuning in. In this video, I'll show you how you can hide a WordPress page or a post from Google. A lot of times this might be a good idea if you're looking to keep something like, say, a thank you page from being indexed on Google search results, or maybe there's a hidden page that you don't want indexed by Google. I'll show you two methods that you can use to do this, and then stick around because then I'll also show you a way that you can control the visibility of a page as well. The first method I'll cover actually involves a plugin. So let's go ahead and head over to our WordPress dashboard. Let's go over to Plugins, Add New. And if you've had your website for a while, you should probably already have this plugin. We'll be using and installing the Yoast SEO plugin. This is a great plugin to use and have on your site to improve your site's SEO. And it's one of the top most popular SEO plugins to have. So let's install that. And then you also want to activate it. And now you see that it's activated. You see it also over here. If you want to go deeper into it on how to set that up, visit our tutorial that walks you through how to set this up step by step as well. Now that we have it installed, let's go to the page that we want to hide from search engines. If you'll scroll down, you'll see an area for the Yoast plugin. Let's click on the gear area. And from here, we want to do two things. From this dropdown, we want to select no index, and we also want to select no follow. And that means that the Google search engine or any of the search engines that deal with these types of meta robots index, they will do a no index. That means they will not index the page. And then they will also do a no follow, which means they will not follow any of the links past that. So you click update and you know it's worked when we do this. Let's open up this page. I'm going to right click and open up this page. And now I want to right click and view page source. And then up at the meta area, you see the meta name robot content. And that means no index and no follow. So Google won't index your page and they won't follow it. The second method that we'll use actually deals with editing the robots.txt file directly. And I'm going to take this out of full screen so you'll see this. So the robots.txt file is found on anybody's site here, if you have one installed, and you see that this is a typical robots.txt file. To edit that directly, you'll want to go ahead and create a robots.txt file on your computer. Go ahead and add the page that you don't want indexed here. When you save this, you'll need to upload it to your website using an FTP. And you'll want to put it into the root folder of your website. Now, there are some disadvantages to using it like this. For one, as you can tell, the robots.txt is visible to anybody. Anybody can go to this page and see what you're disallowing or what you're not indexing. And the other thing is, while some search engines will follow the instructions in the robots.txt file, there are other crawlers that might just ignore it. Now, let's head back over to our dashboard area. Because there's another way that you can do this. So this is the page that I said, no index, no follow. If you want, instead of using the no index, no follow, if you're really just not wanting users to see your page, then you can go and set this up to a password protect. So you go over to the visibility, click on the edit, and instead of public, put password protect, add the password that you want, click OK, click update. And so anybody who wants to access this page, they'll have to know the password in order to see it and view the contents of it. So if your ultimate goal is to just not have certain users see it, then this would be a great idea. Did you learn something helpful from today's video? If so, make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button right here. And thanks for watching.